Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus.
The 13th verse says, when thou criest, of the 57th chapter, let thy companies deliver thee, but the wind shall carry them all away. Vanity shall take them, but he that putteth his trust in me shall possess the land, and shall inherit my holy mountain, and shall say, cast ye up, prepare the way, take up a stumbling block out of the way of my people. For thus saith the high and lofty, one that inhabited eternity, whose name is holy. Mm-hmm. I dwell in the high and holy place,
yes,
with him also that is of a contrite and humble spirit, to revive the spirit of the humble and to revive the heart of the contrite ones. For I will not contend forever, neither will I be always wroth, for the spirit shall fail before me. And the souls which I have made for the iniquity of his covetousness was I wroth. I smote him, and I hid me, and was wroth. And when he went on frowardly in the way of his heart, I have seen his ways and will heal him. I will lead him also and restore comforts unto him and to his mourners. I create the fruit of thy lips,
yeah,
peace to the him that is afar off, and to him that is near, said the Lord, and I will heal him. But the wicked are like the troubled sea when it cannot rest,
mm-hmm,
whose waters cast up mere and dirt. There is no peace, said my God, to,
yes,
the wicked.
Mm-hmm.
And let's focus on the 15th verse. For thus said the high and lofty one that inhabited eternity, whose name is holy. I dwell in the high and holy place, with him also that is of a contrite and humble spirit, to revive the spirit of the,
yes,
humble, and to revive the heart of the contrite ones.
Yes, sir.
You'll repeat after me, humble,
humble
is the way.
Is the way. All right.
If you repeat after me again, humble is the way.
Humble is the way.
I'm going to try to hurry on.
Work on it.
Enough time has been spent already. But humble is the way.
Yes.
We go any other way, it's not going to work.
Amen.
There are many times when we try to do things in ourselves,
yes,
and we fail.
Yes.
And we wonder why we failed, because we really wasn't humble in doing it. We didn't have the right spirit. Webster Dictionary defines humility or the state of being humble, not proud, not arrogant, or assertive, or haughty. The humble person does not think highly of himself,
mm-hmm,
puts others first.
Mm-hmm.
Rank or hierarchy is not important to him. A humble person does not have to get the glory in front of everybody else,
yes,
but gets the glory in secretly.
All right.
Maybe the scripture tells us that if we do things in secretly, he'll bless us openly.
Yes, yes.
And we've got to learn how to not want to get all the glory all of the time.
All right.
If you never say anything about me, it doesn't matter at all.
Yes.
Doesn't matter if you accept me as the assistant pastor, as the coming pastor, as the whatever you want to call me. It really doesn't matter.
Mm-hmm.
What matters is that you have an humble spirit and that you will not be arrogant about the spirit that you possess.
Right.
Yes, you've been in church for a little while, but you still need to be taught a few things. Because
right.
I still see so many mistakes every week when we come into this building.
Yes, yes.
We just depend on everybody else to carry the load.
Mm-hmm.
We expect everything to happen the way we expect it to happen. And when anything gets deviated from our normal program, we ready to hang up, go home, and
yes,
eat.
Yes.
We can eat all the time.
Yeah.
How many times do we think about eating through the weeks that we have spent thus far? How many times do we think of what we're going to eat for lunch, what we're going to eat for dinner, what we're going to eat for breakfast? But how many times do we think about His Word and how our attitude needs to be reflected?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
We have so many, I've never seen so many arrogant church people.
Mm-hmm.
I've never seen so many arrogant saints in my life. We just didn't used to be the way that we are now.
Amen.
Humble is the way.
Yes, yes, yes.
The opposite of humble is arrogant.
Amen.
Or stubborn.
That's right.
And is defined as refusing to give way or consider another option. Cannot be swayed or convinced otherwise. In other words, I don't care what we say, how we stand up here and pray for you. You're not going to change your mind because you are stubborn.
Uh-huh.
You're not going to give Him glory. You're not going to give Him praise. You don't care what's going on. This is not your church. You're really not going to get into it. You're not going to get into nothing.
Yes.
Because, but why waste time in anybody's church? Why waste time coming to church? Why waste time putting on your tennis shoes? And I put on my tennis shoes this morning because I wanted my feet to be comfortable. Plus, it was youth day, so I wanted to get on the youth level. Let them know that we don't have to be all choked up to have a good time. We don't have to be in a certain attire to give Him praise. We come here many times dressed with our long dresses and we still don't give Him glory. We come here a lot of times with no makeup on, looking dry, old skin and everything else, and we still don't give Him no glory. So don't tell me that you've got a certain style that you've got to have to give Him praise.
Amen.
We've got to learn how to come into His glory and into His presence and feel the presence of the Lord, first of all. Many times we can't feel Him. That's why we can't jump up and shout. That's why we can't give Him any kind of praise, because we don't really feel nothing.
All right.
We only feel it if Pastor stands up.
All right.
We'll praise Him. You only feel it if I stand up. You only feel it if Minister Lucky stands up. You only want to get prayed for if certain ones pray for you. I come to let you know you've got to humble your spirit. Calm down, it's going to be all right. Church is not everything that you think it's about all the time. We've come into a time where we can implement some things and do some things just a little bit different.
All right.
Sometimes the way we were taught ain't necessarily the way we should have been taught.
All right.
Sometimes what we've been taught ain't right, and it's hard unprogramming you. You're not going to be unprogrammed. You're not going to try to be unprogrammed. You've got exactly how we should have church. If it's not that, you didn't have church today.
All right.
We can't praise Him unless certain ones are getting blessed.
Right.
You've got to come out of that state.
Yes.
I'm happy when you pay off some stuff.
Yes.
I'm happy because it frees your mind up.
Yes.
And just maybe you'll have a better praise if you're freed up a little bit.
We
miss the mark many times waiting on others to get us together. A lot of times our minds is not humble, and so our spirits is certainly not humble.
Uh-huh.
An humble person trusts in God at all times and always and readily obeys that the Lord says, because he or she understands that he is not self-sufficient.
Uh-huh.
I didn't get here by myself, and I'm not going to go any farther by myself.
All right.
The flesh has been crucified to enough of a state that God can use and trust the person to fulfill what He has. Your flesh has to be crucified. You have to. We must die daily.
Yes.
If we don't die daily, if we don't say, Lord, I'm standing in need of prayer, and I need You, I can't make it without You. We're not going to make it in this life. It's not about your good looks. It's not about your weave. Your haircut. You're in perfect shape. It's not about the earrings that you have, your red shoes, your gray bag, your pearls, your necklaces. It's not none of that stuff. You got a good money in your pocket today, so you're going to praise Him. Lucy, you're
going to
praise Him when you don't have any money in your pocket. And all the person is in full agreement with God's word and His ways. For thus said the high and lofty one that inhabited eternity, whose name is holy. He's holy.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I serve a God that's
holy.
So then I am holy as well because I'm serving someone that's holy.
Yeah.
I dwell in the it says I dwell in the high and holy place with him also that is of a contrite and humble spirit, to revive the spirit of the humble and to revive the heart of the contrite ones. Now, contrite is feeling or expressing remorse or penitence affected by guilt, a broken and a contrite heart.
Uh-huh.
What happens when our mind gets all out of whack?
Yes.
We think we got it. I got to church on time this morning. I'm really doing good. I feel good too when I get here on time. I feel good too, but sometimes if I don't get here on time, I'm still going to feel good.
Amen.
I'm going to feel good because whenever I can praise him, I'm going to feel good because I came into his building and he's done so much for me. So it's not going to matter what you think about me and what everybody else think about me. I got to get everybody out of my mind.
Yeah.
If anybody's talking to me while I'm trying to evaluate myself, I'm thinking on what somebody else said about me. She thinks this. He thinks that. She thinks this. They think this. It doesn't matter what they think. It's what God thinks about
you.
Humble is the way. The Lord will lift up the humble to a higher place with him. God gives special grace, which is undeserved favor. I think Minister Lucky talked about that. Not favor, not being fair to the humble.
All right.
Better to be of an humble spirit than filled with riches taken by force.
Yes.
God promises to revive those who only depend on him. Those who lift themselves up, I'm going to be quick.
That's all right.
Because we done a few things and I know how we hang up. Those who lift themselves up by means of the flesh and for their own glory, God will see it that they are brought down low.
Uh-huh.
He opposes the pride. If you're too proud to praise him, he's too proud to bless you. You're too proud to give him glory. I told you earlier, men, we can praise the Lord. We're not gay, we're not broken wrists if we lift our hands up and tell him thank you.
All right.
I know what my gender is, and I'm not mixed up in my mind. I didn't think I wanted to be a woman. I hadn't thought about being a woman. Glad I'm a man. But if we would start praising him, our houses would become better than they are. We'll set the atmosphere. He'll bless us. God made Adam first. And then he saw that he was lonely and needed some help. So then he brought on Eve. Pulled her out of our rib and made her to help us.
Yes.
But he made us first.
Yes,
we ought to be first in everything we do.
Right.
Not first talking and running our mouths, but first praising him and giving him glory.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come on, you preaching, sir.
You may not like me today.
Go ahead.
But that's all right. God promises to revive those who only depend on him. I believe Pastor, even before he stopped doing a lot of preaching, he was rough on the men. Many times we were coming here and our men go over and just look at each other like, Lord have mercy. What did we do today?
All right.
I'd be saying, and some of the other men be saying, well, what about them women? What about those women? But he wanted us men to be strong. Came out Wednesday night, we had one man in the house. Bunch of women here.
Two
men. What happens with the men? What happens when we can't seem to make God our first priority? I'm still talking about humble in the way. Still talking about you being humble. Yeah, you think I'm not talking to you? I'm talking exactly to you. That's why I'm looking down the Bill Lyle. My brother told me a long time ago, just keep on looking down the Bill Lyle. You're going to get your focus off of what you got to talk about. Because people will frown at you and look at you crazy when you come with the word.
Yeah, all right.
Number person is kind, helpful, and gentle. Generous, not cruel or filled with anger. Every time you talk to a person sometimes in our churches, we angry about something.
All right.
We don't have no patience for the children. We don't have no patience for the adults. We don't have no patience for ourselves.
Yeah.
We waiting on the Lord. We want Him to fix it now. If you don't fix it now, I'm not going to really serve you the way I want to serve you.
Yes.
He don't have to fix nothing now. He's not required to do anything. He don't have to wake you up if he don't want to. So that's what we ought to come into his building with our minds, our hearts on him. God will teach the humble and meek his ways and give them ability to have good judgment. Now the idols in the scripture and their worshippers shall come to Isaiah 57:13-21. The idol and their worshippers shall come to nothing, but those who trust in God's grace shall be brought to the joys of heaven. With the Lord there is neither beginning of days nor end of life. There is no end when you're talking with God. He is the beginning. He's the Alpha and the Omega. He is the beginning. He is the end. He can rewrite the end if he wants to. He can change your situation if he wants to. If you praise him, he can change your situation. I don't care what the people are talking. He can change. Proud changes things. Not because men of standard said it, but because his word says it. Those of us that will seek him. Seek him. My tongue got tired of that. But if you seek him, he will do exactly what he says. His name is holy, and all must know him as a holy God. You don't know him as nothing else. You must know him as a holy God. If you don't reverence him as nothing else, you must reverence him as a holy God. He will have tender regard to those who bring their mind to that condition. If you think about what you are doing and how and what state you are in, then you can realize what state God is in and know that you can't make it without him.
Yes, sir.
You realize where you are, you'll stop looking at everybody else and where they are.
All right.
If you realize what problems you have, you'll stop recognizing all the problems that everybody around you has. If you will stop evaluating me, you can look at the man in the mirror. I think Michael Jackson said it. If you will stop looking at what I'm doing, you can figure out that you ain't doing nothing. He will make his abode with those whose heart he has thus humbled in order to revive and comfort them. I'm almost finished. When troubles last long, even good men are tempted to entertain hard thoughts of God. Therefore, he will not contend forever, for he will not forsake the work of his own hands, nor defeat the purchase of his son's blood. He's not going to sacrifice again his son's dying on the cross. So then we've got to learn how to sacrifice something. He didn't say he was going to send Jesus down here again to sacrifice. He already took care of it on the cross.
Yes,
you got to take care of what you can take care of. You're looking for God to do everything and you don't want to make one step.
All right.
I want a new car. You don't even save up for it.
All right.
You want a new car. At least have all your ducks in a row. Have your money saved up. Look in the blue book and see how much it costs.
Yeah.
Talk to the dealership. Pray about it.
Alright.
Wait on God and go back to the dealership.
Alright.
Tell them exactly what you want.
Yes.
Tell them exactly what you have. But you're going to the table with nothing. Just, I don't have nothing. I want a car. I don't have nothing.
Alright.
I ain't saved up nothing. I ain't even got in my mind what kind of car you want. I don't know, whatever you got. No, you need to have in your mind what you want. We sang a song, whatever you want, God's got it. He's got everything you need.
Preacher,
you know, I love motorcycles, but there's only a few types that I like. I don't like like them with a bunch of junk on it.
Right.
I like them to look a certain way.
Uh-huh.
I like for my cars to look a certain way.
Yeah.
I like to wear my shirt and my tie a certain way.
Yeah.
You know exactly what you like and
right.
Like. You know exactly how you want your husband to act.
Right.
You know how you want your wife to act.
Yeah.
You know what you want out of your marriage. You know what you want out of your single life.
Yeah.
You know what you want in Jesus. You ain't stupid at all. But I want to let you know, you've got to have an almost spirit.
Come on, Hillsong.
All right. Almost the way.
Yeah.
We talk a good talk, but we don't really walk the walk that we talk.
All right, now.
We talk way up here, and we walking down here.
Yeah.
We talk, oh, holy, how about a shiver? We start saying, doing all this, speaking in tongues. But then when it comes down to us having to do some stuff, we ain't really rooted and grounded on the same.
All right.
We just doing a bunch of lip service.
All right.
Have fun.
You preaching, sir.
If I told my wife all the time that I love her, if I tell her all the time, baby, you know I love you. You know I love you. You know I love you. All right,
now, back us up.
Sometimes I'm loving, she's going to be like, prove it to me. Buy me something sometime. You should not talk to you sitting on your throne. You sitting on me. I'm the man of the house. I wear the underwear. I wear the jeans. I wear the pants. When you get home, she pull them right off you. Because your mind, I'm not talking about physically, I'm talking about you don't have it really together in your mind. So then you get home, and you've lost all of your manhood. Don't pray with me. Almost is the way.
Yes, it is.
You know, it's funny. I hear an amen over there. And start humming and get into that really driving. But some of us was on board before he even got to that point. Then when he got to that point, we were like, preach, pastor! Y'all not wait to the favorite spot in your, you know, that you want to get into it. Get into it when it hurts. No pain,
no
gain.
That's
the way. Almost is the way. My spirit has nothing to do with your spirit.
Yes, yes.
My spirit is bad today, it's because my spirit is bad.
All right.
It ain't because you made my spirit bad.
All right.
Why? Because you ain't that strong to make my spirit bad. I'm not in tune with everything today. If I've got an arrogant attitude, it's not because of you. It's, baby, it's because of me. Because I'm just arrogant in my mind. If I don't listen to nobody, nobody has anything to tell me. Can't nobody tell me nothing. I've been on this race a long time. You know, we really hinder ourselves by the stuff that we do.
Amen.
That's the truth.
God will teach the humble and meek his ways and give them ability to have good judgment.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, he will not contend forever, for he will not forsake the work of his own hands, nor defeat the purchase of his son's blood. Covetousness is a sin that has particularly lays men under the divine displeasure. See the sinfulness of sin. See also that troubles cannot reform men unless God's grace work in them. Peace shall be published. Perfect peace. It is the fruit of preaching lips and praying lips. Christ came and preached peace to the Gentiles as well as to the Jews, to after ages who were afar off in time, as well as to those of that age. But the wicked would not be healed by God's grace, therefore would not be healed by his comforts. Their ungoverned lust and passions made them like the troubled sea, is what the scripture is telling us. Also, the terrors of conscience disturbed their enjoyments.
Right.
You ever seen a sea that just keep on waving and waving? You remember when Jesus was on the boat and he told the sea to peace be still? Some of our minds, if we're not really rooted and grounded, we're like that sea is what the scripture's telling us. We just keep on moving and moving and having a bunch of waves, and we're really not rooted and grounded. We don't have stability because our minds is everywhere. Our thoughts are everywhere. We need to get our minds on everything. When I'm riding, I'm not thinking about everything. I'm thinking about a good ride. About home, I'm thinking about church. When I'm sitting there with my head down while the minister's going forth, I'm not thinking about what I'm going to do this week, but I'm thinking on the Holy Ghost. We get our minds right, then everything else would line up. If we are recovered from such an awful state, it is only by the grace of God. We realize that He recovers us from our bad state of mind. And the influence of the Holy Spirit and that new heart from which comes a grateful praise. And then so the fruit of our lips are His gift. We're giving back to Him when we praise Him and magnify Him. We're setting up good timber when we say, thank you, Jesus. Every bill that you helped me pay, thank you, Jesus. Every time I can get out of my bed and walk. You know, I was sitting by my mother's bed on the other night. We were talking about different things concerning her arm and hand, and we were just talking about, we really don't know exactly what, how many times we really need our hands. It reminds me of the church. Every time you get out of sync, we are many members, but we are one body. So then when you get out of whack and you get out of control, it messes up the body of Christ. Are you going to pray with me? Humble is the way. I don't care if you're going through some stuff in your life. You've got to stay humble. If they give me accolades, it really doesn't matter. Humble is the way. If I can clean up the mess in the toilet, I want to be that person. When I go to work sometimes, they tell me that the toilets are stopped up. It wasn't in my job description to clean up the toilets. But I go in that restroom and I unstop the toilets. Why? Because I know I can unstop the toilets. If you do the things that you know you can do, it'll help bring a humble atmosphere to the body of Christ. Humble is the way. Stubborn is not the way. You want everybody to reverence you and give you glory when you do things in the house of God. But every time we ask you to do something, you have a stubborn spirit. Even if you ain't leading the show, you don't want to be the show. If you ain't in the front, you don't want to be doing anything. I don't care if you don't want me to be the pastor or the preacher or whatever. It really doesn't matter because I'm still going to help this man. I'm still going to give me praise while I'm here. I'm still going to hold her up. If you don't ever call me pastor, if you don't ever call me a sister,